book club and seeing you. That was a great intro. I mean, so unique. And to all the other speakers, Sergio Uncle and Ajin Uncle, thank you for like setting the mood. I love it. I'm so glad I made it here early today. But I'm so proud because none of us got ladders today. I thought we were supposed to talk about higher education. Seriously? Not even the students? You could have done something, guys. But it's cool. Alright, we have talked, we've spoken, but we don't have music. So can everybody come to the beat with me?
So to increase my versatility as a singer.
But I found my true calling as an original artist when I wrote my first song at the age of 10, This Love Will Never Fade. Since then, I've written at least 30 more songs, and I'm still writing. I might even get out with an album soon. So stay tuned. Thanks. So, in the words of my favorite rapper, D1, remember, life is a test. Align your passion with your purpose, you'll achieve success. So, I want you to ask yourself, what is my true passion? What is my ultimate purpose in life? And really question yourself about this. Does my higher education align at all with my passion and my purpose? Because that's the only way to reach success, right? Think about it. So many of us fall into the wrong degrees, wrong courses, and we learn stuff that we have absolutely no use for, not because we love to learn it, but because of the pressure that surrounds us to do it. We become doctors not because we love biology and healing people, but because our parents make us good. Stop making me a stereotype. I'll move on. We become engineers not because we actually love software and working with apps, but because all of our other friends are doing it, and they're going to MIT and all those great universities. And all the while, we may have got a passion for chess or soccer or cooking or music or painting, but then we end up shrugging them off as like hobbies because we don't think they'll make us successful in life, and they're only reserved for the talented people. But I'll tell you one thing: hard work beats talent. When talent does not work hard. Ask me where I heard that from? My friend's shirt. I'm not even kidding. But hard work beats talent when talent doesn't work hard. So if we don't work hard, if we do not align our higher education with our passion, how can we ever expect to be successful in what we're doing? Because as Steve Jobs famously orated, the only way to do great work is to love what you do. Don't get me wrong. I think with the mind God gave me, I could have been almost anything. You know, a programmer, a Paralympic athlete, who knows? Maybe even a paleontologist like I wanted to be when I was a baby. And I would have been really successful at it. But I know for a fact that the door that God opened when he closed my ability to walk was music. Because not only did he give me a great mind, but a great voice too. So what is your passion? What is your purpose? And how will your higher education align with the vision of success you have for yourself in life? Step 2, never hold yourself back. One day I came across this great rap song many of you may have heard of, Not Afraid, by none other than Eminem, aka Slim Shady. This song actually struck my chords, and it was so inspirational to me that I said I could not hold myself back from making a cover of it myself and showing it to the world. Who knew, though, that the kid with slim chances of survival would go to sing Slim Shady songs one day? To my pleasant surprise, this cover actually blew up all over the internet and became a worldwide phenomenon. I received praise from some of the most famous celebrities out there. And to date, the cover has gotten over a whopping 65 million views on all social media so far, and counting. So, how does this apply to higher education? So the first thing is, my first challenge for you all is that in higher education, you should never hold yourself back. Never hold yourself back from following your passion in terms of higher education. No matter what it takes, despite the financial difficulty you may have, despite all of the pressure that surrounds you to do something else, if you really have a passion for something, if you really want something badly, you will get it. So follow that no matter what. And if you don't know what you want to be yet, if you're still trying to find out your passion, because I don't believe that when you get to college, you have to be set at what you want to do for the rest of your life. If you're still trying to find out your passion, then don't be afraid to look for different options. And to the teachers of universities and to the universities themselves, don't be afraid to give extra options to people. We shouldn't just reserve music and art and sports as scholarship things or just for specialty universities. They should be there everywhere so that children will come, not just for academia, but for athletics and arts, just like my own school's motto is. So don't be afraid of holding yourself back from that. And most importantly, never make the mistake of holding yourself back from not more knowledge than what you need for your career, because you never know how that's going to apply to you later in life. Moral of the story, knowledge really is power. Use it. Step three. Oh, right, never got to say it. Because I was able to go and display my musical talent to the world and not hold myself back, this is what I came to, all these achievements. And right now, the fact that I'm standing in front of you here today is a huge, humbling blessing. So I'm so glad to be here. And I know that if I can't hold myself back, you can choose not to either. And now step three, help others. Despite the fact that I may have achieved all these amazing things like the United Nations, Madison Square Garden, and even here at the CIF keynote, you know, doing the keynote address here, I still have always felt the need to give back to the society and help others that are in need. So I've been singing pro bono for various nonprofits all over the world, and to date, I've helped to raise almost $1 million for them in total. And that's American dollars, by the way, and we're in Canada, so. But isn't the greatest satisfaction of our lives when we get to personally change someone else's life for the better? Right? Doesn't it give us such an immense amount of gratitude? That's why I feel it is absolutely necessary that we have to spread our knowledge all across the world. Because guess what? Even in our technologically advanced world, there are still places where education does not exist as an institution yet. So what can we do to share our knowledge? Well, we can solve world problems. We can actively volunteer in those areas. We can raise funds for people to go out to those areas. And even we can raise funds so that other people who can't afford education can go to a university and get their schooling. Because as we know, that's a major problem today. So if we can raise funds, we can help other people follow their dreams. And finally, we can even raise awareness of the situation and help spread the message so that other people who may be more capable than us can actually change the world. And even if we can't do any of this, we can at least teach the people around us so that our knowledge does not stay with us alone. And then maybe one day they'll go out and change the world, and you can claim all the credit for teaching them. They'll be like, yeah, I'm their guru. So, lesson is, never keep knowledge to yourself. It is only meant to be spread. And the last, but not least step, dream big. None of this would have ever happened if I had not dreamt big. Neither would this world have been as big as it is if its inventors hadn't dreamt big. Neither would this event have been as big as it is if the CIF founders had not dreamt big in their Canada-India relations agenda. And so, my biggest dream, however, as a musician, is still yet to be accomplished. To perform in front of at least a billion, yeah, you heard me right, not a million, a billion people one day. And I want to leave my footprints, or rather track prints, into the sand of legacy so deep, not even a tsunami can erase it. And I firmly believe that all of us, great or small, should strive for such big goals. Don't you want to be remembered when you leave this earth? I mean, I have many plans for myself, especially in the musical career, besides writing albums and writing songs and going on concerts and stuff. And that includes going for a bachelor's degree online from Berklee College of Music. But most importantly, I want to sparsh or touch everyone's hearts all over the world. And I want to spread the message that no matter what happens in your life, you should never, ever give up on your passion. Because look, everyone goes through struggles in life, right? I know, because I have to deal with constant fractures and lots of pain. But I really know that if I can turn the word impossible into impossible in my life, you can too. If you can believe it, you can achieve it. And I firmly believe that if you push forward and have faith, you will make it big anywhere in life. So the only question that remains is your higher education helping you reach a higher dream? Thank you.